Hi, this is Gina Crochet Gal. This is take like 100 already. I am recording from a different device and I don't know where to look on the screen. It's different. Anyways, I'm going to try it again. So hopefully this is the last take. Today, I'm going to be sharing some items that I've been working on, and it's going to be a combination of everything. Crochet, cross stitch, and just like whatever comes up. Just some stuff that I have here on the side, and yeah, so let's go ahead and get started. I hope everyone had a very nice Memorial Day weekend. I didn't get to barbecue like I wanted because it was so windy outside. I had to bring my barbecue stuff inside and had to cook inside, but that was okay. We had a nice day anyway. Okay, first off, I'm going to share crochet. And a few weeks back, I participated in a carousel package swap, and that was put on by Sonia at Cat Crazy Creations. And one of the patterns that I wanted to do from that magazine was called Patchwork Kitty, which is one that she did as well. But mine, I didn't follow the pattern completely because I had scraps of variegated yarns, not, you know, small balls of solids. So I did mine in variegated scraps. So here is what my Patchwork Kitty looks like. Here. Now her head is done in variegated white, yellow, blue, and green. And the ears, body, and part of the tail is done in some earth tones. And they are browns and greens and blues and a mauve color, I believe, is in there. Really pretty yarn. I really like this yarn. And then I chose to do the legs in some pretty funky bright color. Pinks and red and green, and looks like a real hot pink color. And then the paws I did in variegated blues and white. Now the only thing that I did different was, I believe it's pronounced the haunch. I did not add that. I didn't know how to do that for some reason. I couldn't read it and process it at the same time. So I just went ahead and attached the limbs just like I do my other dolls. And the ears I changed up as well. I did them double so that they stand up firm. And for the face features, I stitched on the whiskers as well as the nose and the mouth and the eyes. So that's what my version of Patchwork Kitty looks like. She was fun. What I plan to do is make this kitty in solid color, see what it looks like. I plan on doing that. The next item I have to show was for an order, and this is a bunny. It's a yellow bunny, and he stands, I don't know, I see yellow boy, I don't know, could be a girl doll too, but she's about, whatever, 12 inches long, tall. And how I make the bunny is how I usually do it, the process, is I make all the body parts first. The ears, then I do the arms and the legs, and then I stuff those parts. Now on this one, I forgot to stuff the arms. And I thought, you know what, I actually like the way it looks like this, because when you stuff the arms, they tend to go up a little bit and you have to stitch it on the inside. Well, you don't have to do it if they're not stuffed. So I think it looks okay like that. So anyways, after I do make all the limbs, I do the head and the body, and it is one piece. And after that's done, I stuff the body and the head, and then I start attaching the limbs. First is the muzzle, But before I put the muzzle on, I of course stitch on the nose and the mouth first. Then I attach the muzzle, then I do the eyes, because for me, I like to have the muzzle put on first so I can see where the placement is that I want on this particular or that particular project. Sometimes closer together it looks cute, makes them look more babyish. So for this one, I put them a little further apart. Yep. And then I attach everything else, the head, the arms, and then the legs. And then last, I add the little cottontail. So that is the bunny. I still have two available on my Etsy store, as well as a couple of other mermaids. So if anybody's interested, go ahead and grab those. Okay, then I have a tablet sleeve that I made. And the reason I made that was because I went out of town last week for a few days, and I wanted a cover for my tablet, which I didn't have, so I crocheted one. And this is what it looks like. I added three buttons. I have a flap. Really crazy bright colors. I do plan on making another one. I don't know if I'm going to undo this one or just make another one altogether, because this one got a little bit stretched out, and you know, when we make crocheted items, they tend to stretch out with use. So I'm going to make it a little bit smaller, so when it does stretch out, it'll still be a tight fit around the tablet. So I made that. And then the next item I have to share are some coasters. Now when I'm crocheting or doing cross stitch or whatever, it just depends on the coolest part of the home usually. I'm either in my bedroom or in my living room area, or I sit on my chair close to the door, wherever. Anyways, I find myself moving everything from place to place, one being coasters. And I thought to myself, well, that's kind of silly. Just make one, right? So that's what I did. this is what it looks like. These little coasters here. I'm so sorry. I don't know where to look on this because I don't see a light or anything. Anyway, this pattern, I believe, and please forgive me, I am so bad at, when I'm looking at other tutorials, when I'm learning things or getting patterns from other people that I make, I always forget to jot down their name. But I do believe it was a pattern from Bella Coco's channel. Not positive though. So it's just your flat circle with a scalloped edge. Now this one actually curls up a little bit, so I'm probably going to put some more increases in it. Just going to play around with that pattern. So that's the other item I've been doing. Okay, that's it for crochet, I think. Okay, so next are the cross stitch items. Now the one which was Believe, I haven't done any of it, really. I don't think I've done anything since the last time I showed this one. I've only completed her apron area up towards the chest area, her neck, and the bottom of her chin. That's it. But I'll go ahead and show it to you anyway. Yeah, I haven't done any of it. I'm not into the what do you call it? The rotation yet. For me right now, I like to just work on a project when I want to, because sometimes I either get tired of it and want to change, or I'm excited about where I'm at and want to keep going. So for now, I'm not doing any rotating. It's kind of like, okay, no rules. Okay, so the next one was the Live Simply. I'm finished. I'm done. I think the last time that I showed it, I was around this top area. So I went ahead and completed that, and of course filled in all the little spots, including the wording in the center. And I finished it the night before last. So I'm really excited about that. I finished one. Well, a bigger one. My first finish was the owl, the little owl kit, which I still haven't completely finished yet. I'll get there. So this is what it looks like. Oops. Dropping everything. Okay, so here is what we have. I think the colors in it are so pretty. Love these colors. Now, what I plan on doing, I don't know if I mentioned it in the last video, but I'm going to try this. Hopefully it'll work. I'm going to cut maybe 2 inches of the top and adhere it with Wonder Under. I believe that's what it's called. It's that iron-on adhesive. And I'm going to try to put it, attach it to the bottom here so that it looks more centered. And I plan on making a pillow with it. So I'm going to try it, see what happens. I'll let you know how it goes. And I haven't started that little the little cat one either, so plan to pick that up soon. Okay, and I think that's about it. I'll show you the cat one just real quick. I like to save these little baggies. These come like when you buy curtains and stuff. I always save these things for project bags. I like stuff like that. So here's the kitty cross stitch that I plan on doing. One of these evenings I'll get it started. Okay, and lastly, I'd just like to share with you, I don't think I've mentioned it in any other videos, I do like to quilt, and I do have a quilting channel also. I have two that are spelled different. One is Quilt, Q-W-I-L-T-I-N gal, and the other one is regular spelled Quilt, Q. No, I think I just said the same thing. One is Q-W-I-L-T, and the second one is Q-U-I-L-T, and it's Quilton Gal. And the reason I have two is because when Google started combining email addresses and passwords, I got crazy, and I couldn't get into my Quilton Gal account, so I had to create another one. And what I do with that is just view quilting videos or sewing videos, whatever, to try to keep it separate. I'm not sure if I'm going to incorporate quilting in this channel or just keep it separate. I don't know, because I don't know how involved I'm going to get into it again. But I do enjoy it. I have or had a lot of fabric, and I lost a lot of my stuff. Well, we won't get into that, but I've slowly started collecting all the tools that I need to start quilting again. And thankfully, I've had family members donate items to me, and I'm really happy about that. So I think I have a good amount of stash now. So this past weekend, which I sadly didn't do, I wanted to create a table runner or some kind of wall hanging in a patriotic theme. So I went online, and I went to quilterscachet.com, and it's a website that allows you to print patterns, quilting patterns. And it's really a really good site. It's got lots of nice blocks, different sizes. And because I haven't quilted in such a long time, I thought I'd start off with an easy block. Okay. This is a 9-inch block, and in the center, I believe the blocks are 4 inches, not quite sure. It's a 9-inch block, so I don't know what the sizes of the main block is. 4 1/4. Yeah, 4 1/4, I think. So anyway, it's a 9-inch block with some solid blocks, and then I don't remember that cut. It's been a while since I've quilted, so I have to get familiar with the names of the blocks again. So yeah, this pattern is called Dolly Madison's Star Number 2. And unfortunately, I didn't do what I wanted to do because I was really inspired this past weekend, to make a patriotic quilt. So, but it's in the works. I have it in my mind already to go outside and pull some fabric. Now the next one I chose is called Wedding Rings 2. And here's the block. I believe this is a 10-inch block. Yes, 10-inch. And I'm not necessarily going to use these colors. I wanted to do them in red, white, and blue. I thought that would make a nice table runner. So that is that. And anyway, that's it for today. I hope everyone had a great weekend and got a lot of fun crafting in, crocheting, cross-stitching, all sorts of fun stuff. Well, that's it for today. I'm going to finish off my coffee. I'm a little tired. I just got home from therapy for my hands. So we'll talk to you soon. Happy crocheting craft day. Bye.